Welcome to a new video of my Unity MMO tutorial series, and today we will continue with our character selection. Okay, at first we go to the server connection handler where we added the char selection request, and we can delete the if function and now we can create some variables. So now we get the characters from our user repository and get characters by ID, and we take our connection, our auth store and the connection ID, and put it into a variable. And now we have to take all our characters out of it. So we create for each, and the for each will be the character model, and we call it characters. And yeah, I will call it chars, or yeah, I will call it chars in characters. So we take our character model, we need to edit, and it's using master server user models.user, and now we can say what char name is equal to chars.charName, and yeah, now we can add our package parser dot parse package to stream, and we create a new character selection response package, and now we can add some variables. So we need to check in our character creation package the selection response, and then we have the, I will copy this and put it here so I can see the hierarchy. So at first it is is valid is a true function, then we say the error message is equal to error message types dot success, and after this we edit the char ID, and the char ID we have to declare with war char ID equal to chars dot ID, and now we can add the char ID here, and at last we have the char name, and this will be our char name. So we can put these variables here as well, but we don't need I forgot something, and this is our connection.writer. Okay, And that's all for sending our stuff to the server. So he will send it twice, of course, or 8 times or more. And therefore we go to the we will do it in a later video. We can add a new variable here and call it we will call it max characters, and we will put it to 8, so we can ask later for getting the max characters, so you can change it like you want. Okay, and now we have to go to the client manager and check save character to database is okay. But after this, we have to add a new variable and we say get component in children, and we use the menu manager and say true, and then we can say t dot character selection menu, and therefore we go to the menu manager and check how the character selection is called, and yeah, now we can go to our Unity engine. And here is it. And we go to the scenes character. And as you can see, we don't have any character selection scene here. So we right click on the folder and create a new scene there. And we call it like we copied it and open the scene. And now we can add game object UI, and yeah, let's start with a panel, and in this panel we add a vertical layer group, and I will put in every field 10, and we will use the upper right, and you can choose what you want, but I want to add in this field our character selection. So this will be in this field. And now we can add something new. So at first we can you can add a background image or something else in here, but I will change the color of the background and make it a little bit darker. And now we add a scroll view and we drag and drop it in this field. And yeah, now let's change sorry, I did something wrong. Change the width, and now we can drag and drop here, as you can see, and yeah, let's make it a width of 200. And if you click on play, it's like this. And yeah, Let's add in the viewport. You have the viewport and the content field. And in the content field, we add a button. So right click UI button. And we will drag and drop to the top. And I will change the width to 117 and 100. And now we can drag and drop this one, and this text we can leave empty, but for now I will add it like this because we want to add a char name here. And now we can duplicate it and drag and drop it. And for our case, we will use this 3 times. And we can change in the viewport. And we can delete the horizontal scroll bar because we don't need it. And the vertical scroll bar so if we it like this, but the vertical scroll bar Yeah, I don't know why I will fix this in the next video, I guess. I don't know why I cannot drag and drop it down. But it's no problem because only. Yeah, I will check it in a later video. If we click on play, you can see there is no scroll bar and you can see the characters. You can change it as well. It's only for testing reasons. We will, yeah, do it in a later case a little bit better. And the last thing I will add is a UI button. And I have to change sorry, I drag and drop the button in the wrong place, so I will try to delete. And we need to go to the canvas now and add a UI button. And I will drag and drop it down to the. And now we can say enter world, and if you click on play you can see enter world, and I will anchor it on the top on the bottom. And the next steps we will do in the next video, because now the button is down below. And when you click on a character, the character will appear here in the middle with the UMA receipt. And yeah, let's do it in the next video. If you like my content, you can subscribe me on Patreon or leave a like on my videos, or write down a comment. And if you need any help, you can write it down in a comment as well, or join my Discord server. Thank you for watching.